In this video, I'll be going over the backstory of Rick Ross on My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. There's some angry Kanye involved too. It's the last day of making My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. Kanye has to turn in the record tomorrow. He's been recording this album since 2009, and tomorrow is the day he has to turn it in. Over $3 million has been spent on this album, making it one of the most expensive albums ever. He had holed up in Hawaii to make a masterpiece. He imported his favorite artists and producers so they could work on this. He put everything in this album, but Kanye feels like it's missing something. It's 2009. Most rappers like to fuck around during studio sessions, both metaphorically and literally, smoke weed and not be the most productive during their sessions. When Kanye was working on My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy, it was insanity. He booked 3 studio rooms simultaneously for 24 hours to work on this album. Even though he had rented a glass enclosed mansion, 90% of the time, the only sleep he ever got was the power naps in his studio or a fancy 90-minute sleep on the couch. Engineers worked over the clock and West hopped from room to room. He literally hired 2 chefs, one for cold food and one for hot food. He asked people their opinions on how the music sounded. Every person had a voice and an idea, and he was looking forward to what they had to say. His work ethic was absolutely insane. This album was one of the most expensive albums to ever be made because it included all these artists and a lot of extremely good producers. Even though a lot of these artists never actually made it to the final cut of the album, he had also invited this one man who went by the name of Rick Ross, who would deliver arguably the best verse on the album. Rick Ross was never actually intended to be on MBDTF. He was invited to Hawaii to work on the album with West. While he was there, Kanye was recording Monster, and he was so impressed with this, he asked if he could deliver an intro to the song. Kanye liked his work and invited him back to the studio several months later to deliver one final verse. 2010, this is the last day before turning in the album. I had already recorded a verse to Devil in a New Dress in Hawaii. Kanye had already released the song as part of his weekly Good Fridays series, except he hadn't kept my verse on there. But when I met up with Kanye in New York at the final hour of his album, he had a new version of the song. His engineer Mike Dean had added this mean guitar solo breakdown at the end of it that Kanye wanted me to come in after, but he wanted me to write a new verse. He didn't like the one I'd done in Hawaii. "I know that you can do something better than that." That's what he said. Then he stood up, turned around and walked out the studio. It was good that he left. I needed a minute to process what had just happened. In all my years, no one had ever asked me to rewrite a verse before. Even when I was a nobody, ghostwriting for artists way bigger than me, no one had ever said something like that. I was shocked, but I wasn't offended. I wasn't pissed. That surprised me too. I knew Kanye hasn't said that to upset me. He was pushing me the same way he had been pushing everybody in Hawaii. The same way he was pushing himself to do something even greater. So the ball was in my court. I could either take his request as disrespect or I could take him up on his challenge. I decided on the latter. It was actually the last day before Kanye had to turn the record in, and I think that pressure just made it that much more special to me. When Rick Ross laid the verse 30 minutes later, he was extremely happy, Kanye was extremely happy, and most important of all, the fans were extremely happy. This was a filler video while I'm working on a longer video, so if you liked finding out the backstory of this song, subscribe for more. According to this comment, I never miss.